ওপেন হয়েছিল শেষ।
স্যার ওই থার্ডে যেরকম ছিল সেরকমই,
এই যে যেটা
Please. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. We are indeed privileged to welcome you this afternoon to this investors meet, which we are organizing on land monetization opportunities with Durgapur Projects Limited. We are honored to have with us Mr. S. Suresh Kumar, IAS, Additional Chief Secretary, Department of Power, Government of West Bengal. Grateful, sir, for your presence. We are equally privileged to have amongst us Mr. Anurag Srivastava, IAS, Special Secretary, Department of Industries, Government of West Bengal. Thank you, sir, for your presence. We have amongst us the Managing Director, Mr. Gautam Bishaj of DPL, Director of Finance, Mr. Anjan Banerjee. Thank you, sir, for your gracious presence. We also have amongst us Mr. Praloy Majumdar. He is a Joint Secretary. Thank you, sir, for your gracious presence. Nonetheless, we have with us our ICC President, Mr. Pradeep Sureka. Thank you, sir. We have Mr. Sudeep Datta, Partner ENY and Chairman of the National Expert Committee on Infrastructure, and Madam Chandana Rai Chaudhary, Director ENY. Thank you, sir, for your gracious presence. We have amongst us other eminent dignitaries. Others are on the way and they'll join, but we will start, sir, with your permission. Having said that, may we request our president, Mr. Pradeep Sureka, welcome all the dignitaries on the dais with the traditional uttorio. To Mr. S. Suresh Kumar. Thank you, sir. Mr. Anurag Srivastava, sir. Thank you, sir. To Honorable Mr. Praloy Majumdar. To Mr. Gautam Biswas, Managing Director, DPL. To Mr. Anjan Banerjee, Director of Finance. To our very own sir, Mr. Sudeep Datta, who is a partner EY and also our chairman. And Madam Chandana Rai Chaudhary, who is your head of entire initiative with DPL. Thank you. thank you, sir. With this, may I request Ms. Chandana Rai Chaudhary, Director, ENY, to please deliver the welcome address. Please, madam.
Thank you, Paramita. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. On behalf of Government of West Bengal, Durgapur Projects Limited, Indian Chamber of Commerce, and Ernst & Young, we welcome all of you in this investors meet. We appreciate and are grateful to all of you for taking your time out of your busy schedule and joining us. We are happy that for the grace, I mean, august presence of Mr. Suresh Kumar, additional chief, joining us along with his senior officials. Also, Mr. Anurag Srivastava for joining us and contributing his thoughts with us. And it's my privilege to invite Mr. Rekha, President ICC, to share his thoughts on this event with us now. Thank you.
Good afternoon to all. Mr. Suresh Kumar, IS Additional Chief Secretary, Department of Power, Government of West Bengal, my other dignitaries on the dais and off the dais, ladies and gentlemen, urban land is a tangible asset that has not been tapped to the fullest potential. Monetization of land is gaining currency as stakeholders are warming up to the idea of unlocking the tremendous benefits of this process. The commercial development of land accelerates the real estate prospects in the vicinity and fuels the demand for infrastructure, such as retail development, banking, housing, and so many other allied industries. It also contributes to planned urbanization, boosts commerce and generates a huge amount of employment. Land exchange can also be used as an effective instrument if suitable options exist. The crucial step in the land monetization process is to map the vacant lands, enlist these in the public domain. The steps will ensure transparency and accountability in the monetization process. Land monetization should entail the engagement of all the stakeholders. And I'm happy that Suresh Kumar ji and DPL, they are having this process of meeting investors. I congratulate them on this process. Land monetization should entail the engagement of all the stakeholders. Mass sensitization and awareness program should be organized for the local community. Educate them on the benefits of the process. Sometimes, you know, when you are doing something, there's always some resistance to government land being monetized. So I think it's also important to not only look at the business partners, but also look at the public at large and engage them also in this process. Real estate developers and relevant stakeholders in this segment are formidable partners in the process. Partnering with the government not only allows stakeholders to tap new avenues and geographical regions, but also diversify their offerings and generate revenue. It reinforces the role in contributing to urban development and shaping the growth trajectory of the economy. These trends in 100 crores and Aleppo for over 400 crores respectively are pointers, not just for the potential of land monetization, but also a growing realization of the importance of this initiative as an engine for economic growth. And especially in Bengal, when you have so many title issues on private lands, when it comes to government land, we as developers, we as investors know that we are getting title or a clean title. That goes a long way. Further, the change of the current announcement of the West Bengal government to give land on freehold is a testimony of the idea of monetization of land and the need to monetize this land. I mean, this particular process which the government has announced is really, really very, very encouraging. It will not only give confidence to us investors, sir, it will give confidence to the people who will buy into our projects later on. And also it simplifies a lot of the transaction costs like tax and statutory compliances. So this is definitely, sir, a very, very welcome move. And I congratulate the West Bengal government for taking this initiative. So apart from Kolkata, we always talk about Kolkata, cities like Siliguri, Haldia, Asansol, Durgapur, Havra are playing promising roles in shaping the future of our state. These cities have witnessed rapid industrialization and have potential to bring the best of economic development of West Bengal. The Durgapur-Asansol belt in particular, with its industrial base and now having a new airport, which is now getting active, excellent rail, road, education, training infrastructure, and its pool of trained manpower is brimming with opportunity and must be tapped in full potential. The representatives from Durgapur Project Limited are here today to explain the land bank which they have and how they wish to monetize the land bank. And I look forward, and we all look forward to hearing from them as to how we take this forward. And at ICC, we assure you of our regular participation in this process with you. And so we look forward to your interaction. Thank you, sir.
We would now request Mr. Anjal Banerjee, Director of Finance, DPL, to give a presentation on DPL.
A very good afternoon to all ladies and gentlemen. Respected Sri S. Suresh Kumar Sir, Additional Chief Secretary, Power Department, Government of West Bengal. Sri Honurag Srivastav, Special Secretary, Department of Commerce and Industries, Government of West Bengal. Sri Polnai Mojumdar, Joint Secretary, Power Department, Government of West Bengal. Sri Gautam Biswas, Managing Director, Durgapur Projects Limited. Sri Pradeep Sureka, President, ICC and Managing Director, Sureka Group. Sri Sudeep Datta, Partner and Leader, Urban Sector, Mrs. ENY. And Madam Chandana Rai Choudhury, Director, ENY. And all distinguished guests, officials from Power Department, Mrs. Ernst & Young, Indian Chamber of Commerce, Durgapur Projects Limited. At the outset, I welcome everyone heartily to this investor meet, which has been organized by C and Mrs. ENY, and the purpose of which has been explained by my predecessor. And before we deliberate in details on the subject, I would like to briefly introduce Durgapur Projects Limited through a small presentation. Durgapur Projects Limited was incorporated in the year 1961, 6 September 1961, and it was the first PSU and Government of West Bengal undertaking. And it was envisioned as an industry for industries. It was having multifunctional utilities like, which consisting of coke oven, group of plants, gas grid project, thermal power project, and power distribution, transmission, water works, and a lot of things. After 2019, as a part of reconstruction of this company, it was converted into a Genco only, and its transmission and distribution business was handed over to TCL and DCL respectively. So from 2009, it is operating only as a Genco. It is having two units, one with 300 megawatt capacity and other 250 megawatt capacity. Also, it is having a waterworks which caters the need of its captive use and also to the surrounding industries and township for water supply. And DPL is also having a mines having a capacity of 1 million ton per year. Now, coming to this land bank and this monetization of land, this decision was taken by Government of West Bengal as a part of restructuring DPL. And as it is having a huge chunk of land, certain land portion was identified for monetization. And to facilitate this thing, this seminar, this meet has been organized with the help of ENY. ENY is working as a transaction advisor and assisting DPL in monetization of the land. Now I will the balance part regarding monetization and details land parcels will be explained by ENY team. So I now hand over to them. Thank you.
So before we move on to our presentation, can I invite Mr. Gautam Biswas, Managing Director, to speak about this initiative?
A very good afternoon, everyone. Honorable SES Powers, Sri Suresh Kumar Sir, Sri Anurag Srivastava, Special Secretary, Department of Commerce and Industry, Sri Pralay Mojumdar, Joint Secretary, Department of Power, Mr. Pradeep Surekha, President, Indian Chamber of Commerce, Kolkata Chapter, Mr. Sudip Datta, partner and leader of Urban Sector, Madam Chandana, and my colleague, Mr. Anjan Banerjee, Director of Finance, DPL, and other distinguished guests from the industry and corporate sector. At the outset, in this investor meet, which is jointly organized by ICC Kolkata and ENY on behalf of Power Department and DPL. I would like to thank ICC and ENY for organizing this event. This is indeed a great pleasure to share a few points pertaining to this event. I know Mr. Banerjee has already given you a brief about DPL and its business activities right now. I would like to supplement it further with few more points. It is basically to give you a context about today's event. I mentioned DPL has a huge chunk of land parcel at its possession since its inception in the year 1961. Some of them are located at prime locations at Durgapur, and some of them are at places at Ban, Howrah, and Hooghly. We have received clearance from the Finance Department of Government of West Bengal to monetize some of these land parcels to support the restructuring activities of DPL and also to fund its future growth. So the details of the land parcels and the probable model for monetization will be deliberated in the presentation to be made by ENY subsequently. I am sure the industry representative will find lots of value proposition in the said land parcels, and they will definitely may come out projects which will have economic value, economic prospects for the industry as well as for the state. I would further request you to clarify your Q&A session for informed decision going forward. I am looking forward to this event to be an interactive session and hope it will achieve its desired objective. Thank you all once again.
So thank you, sir. I think what we, first of all, I think we are very grateful that we have representation from practically all the senior real estate developers in the city. So we are very grateful for all of you to come. There is a large number of pockets of land which DPL intends to monetize. So what we'll do is we will quickly run through each of these sites, which will give you an idea of where the sites are, what are the sizes, etc. And thereafter, what we would like to, what we want to do is to take your views on how do we bid it out, what is the best way of monetizing it. We have not, as of now, fixed up what are the usages of the land. Some of the lands are good for residential, some of the lands are good for industrial park. Some of them are very small, of 2 acres. There are some at 24 acres. There are some at 100 acres. So maybe we'll also look at you as to your suggestion as to how do we break the plots into smaller pieces. And of course, we will always talk about leasing and freehold. But right at this point of time, I would request my colleagues to just take you through the slides, and then we will go into a more interactive session.
DPL has its land parcels spread across the southern part of West Bengal, mostly on Howrah, Hooghly, Purva Bardhaman, and Pashchim Bardhaman districts. As of now, for the phase one of the development, DPL has earmarked 86 acres of land. One in Howrah, one in Hooghly, one in Purva Bardhaman, and 5 plots in Poshim Bardhaman, which is the Durgapur city itself. Going forward, this is the site. This is in Piali, Durgapur, and Poshim Bardhaman. So Durgapur does not need any introduction. This is one of the major urban centers and the planned industrial city of West Bengal. It has got excellent urban infrastructure. So our site is near the Durgapur city center. It is along the and just opposite side to the city center and other urban amenities of Durgapur. So this is the land parcel. We have two land parcels. Combined land parcel area is 24 acres. And I have already mentioned, this is located at the heart of the city. This is very close to the national highway. Yes, direct access. And of course, it is located within Durgapur Municipal Corporation and under the jurisdiction of DPL, it has got excellent urban amenities and urban infrastructure as well. Forward, this is another site, Durgapur itself. This is Span Pipe Factory. This is located near the Durgapur railway station. This is on BTR Sharoni, and this is just 300 meters away from the Durgapur railway station. So this is the site. It's a continuous line land parcels of 9.25 acres of size. This is a flat vacant land, very close to Durgapur railway station that I mentioned. This land parcel is located on the BC Avenue, and because of its proximity to the railway station and a busy highway, the surrounding area has got a quite developed commercial and retail areas around it. And of course, this site also enjoys infrastructure and social amenities because of its location. Going forward, this is Raturia Pump House, another site. This site lies in the banks of Damodar River. This is also connected via Hanuman Sharoni. This is 150 meters away from Hanuman Sharoni and abuts very close to the Damodar River itself. And as of now, we have also observed that we are having many leisure destinations such as resorts and all along this river. And this area also has pretty good connectivity, as you can see. And this is also a land of more than 2 acres of size. This has also a very good potential in terms of. Going forward, we have another land pass at Gopinathpur Moja. This is also in Durgapur. This also falls under the larger township of Durgapur Projects Limited. This also abuts the Hanuman Sharoni. Here we have land, which is in the northern side of Hanuman Sharoni and near the Oven area of Durgapur. The total area of this site combined is 17 acres, and the land sizes vary from 5 to 6 acres in its size. So they have a good connectivity via railway and road, as you can see. The lands are flat in nature. They are they have pretty good social and physical amenities. Going forward, we have another land at Birbhanpur Moja. This is also close to the Durgapur railway station. So here also we have multiple land parcels as measuring a total of more than 28 acres of size. These sites are also very close to the Durgapur railway station, approximately 750 meters. 750 meters. This is also inside the developed township of Durgapur Projects Limited. So this has got all the urban amenities which is needed. And also near the site, we have social amenities that we can expect for township to develop. Going forward now, this site is in Howrah district in Bali. As we all know that Bali is has got multiple freeways and national highways and multiple railway lines as well. This is one of the densest areas in the region. And this is our site. This is located next to the Durgapur Expressway. And within 1 kilometer radius, we have 3 railway stations, Bali Halt Railway Station, Bali Ghat Railway Station, and Bali Station. And of course, the Durgapur Highway is walking distance from the site itself. The site the Bali Halt Railway Station is in fact only 50 meters away from the site. This is a pretty dense neighborhood with residential apartments mushrooming around it. But this land is 3.03 acres of size, which is quite big compared to the other projects in this area. And this is located in a developed residential area with proper road and railway connectivity, as well as the ferry routes across the river. Next, this is another land in Bardhaman. So Bardhaman is also one of the major urban centers of West Bengal. This land abuts the Katwa Bardhaman road, which is like 1.2 kilometers away from the Bardhaman railway station, which is on the northern side of the Bardhaman railway station. We have a line land abutting Bardhaman Katwa road. So mostly this surrounding neighborhood is residential, and also we have commercial developments along the Katwa Bardhaman road. This area is also served by the Bardhaman Municipal Corporation. So all the physical amenities and the physical infrastructures are in place for this site. Going forward, this is Dhoniakhali district. This is Dhoniakhali in Hooghly district. So this land is located on the Chuchura Dankuni road. This is Asian Highway or the NH19, and this is very close to the Dhoniakhali. The strategic advantage of this site is this is very close to the Dhoniakhali railway station. So this land is like in the walking distance from the Dhoniakhali railway station and Dhoniakhali bus stop as well. And due to the good connectivity of this particular area, the surrounding areas we are seeing developments such as polytechnic institutions, medical and diagnostic center, some industrial developments, bank, etc. is coming up around the site. There are other land parcels of DPL as well. These land parcels are being considered by the authority for to be taken up in the further phases. So I would go through this land parcels one by one. Under disposition. So all these land parcels are located in Durgapur. As you can see in this map, I have highlighted these maps in this bright yellow. So some of the lands are on National Highway 19 and some of the lands are Hanuman Sharani. All these lands have very good urban infrastructure and good connectivity. So this is the first land that we would like to discuss. This is the Bidhannagar Township in Durgapur. This is a very prime location in Durgapur, as we all know. Here we have our site. The total site area is more than 120 acres of area. We have prominent real estate developments happening around the site, and needless to say that we have many major urban infrastructure and social amenities around these sites. And these are other sites which we have around Hanuman Sharani. So the size of these sites vary from 5 acres to 36 acres. I'll quickly go through each and every site. So this is the first site. This abuts Hanuman Sharani, and this is between Hanuman Sharani and the railway line. This is a 23 acre site. Then we have another site. This site is more than 36 acres. And none of these sites, all the sites are like bounded and under the jurisdiction of DPL without any activities going on at present. So next site, this is also a 25 acre site. This is like slightly on the southern part. And this site also has, and all these sites have very good frontage. Like the previous two sites have more than 500 meters of frontage. And even this site has got 150 meters of frontage on Hanuman Sharani itself. Going forward, this is another site abutting Hanuman Sharani. This site also has got a 350 meters of frontage on Hanuman Sharani and 22.75 acres land, flat terrain, and without any activities as of now. Going forward, another 24 acres site. This is also in the similar area. Of course, all these sites are within the jurisdiction and the township area of DPL. So all these sites have very good infrastructure facilities and good connectivity where DPL has already laid. Going forward, these are other slides. This site is on a bit southern side. This is near the Damodar River, well connected. This is another site, a smaller size, 7.8 acres. And we have other sites in the same area. These are like in the tune of 6 to 8 acres. So another site we have, this is on Piali. This site abuts the National Highway 19. This is like 250 meters away from the city center. And this is one of the prime lands that we have here. Again, in Birbhanpur Mauja, this is on Hanuman Sharani next to the coke oven above the railway station.
Thanks a lot, Patanjali. So all of these lands that we just spoken about are all with DPL, clear ownership. There is no encroachment in any of the land. And there is an approval from the finance department and the cabinet of taking this out. So the mode of operandi, whether it will be industrial or retail, is something that we are studying. Some of these land that we were talking at the later part, 24 acres, 20 acres, are also near the Durgapur industrial bit. So some of them may be suitable for industrial parks also. So so that's broadly gives a vision of this, of the land. And what we also expect is with growing urbanization, the next level of urbanization are going to go very strong on the tier 2, tier 3 cities. So these are obviously natural future growth cities. So what I would request Mr. Anurag Srivastava to share his thoughts.
Thank you, sir. I thank Suresh Kumar, sir, DPL, ICC, and EY for inviting me here. I'm representing Industries Department and WIDC here. I'm happy to be here because the feedback that comes from you is actually what can be implemented in the field. So very small additional addition to the what DPL is doing. As you know, Honorable Chief Minister has announced industrial cum economic corridor. The corridor will run from Raghunathpur till Tajpur, but it will also be extending from Asansol till Dankuni. So that area stretch would be covered. And in this, WBIDC would be developing certain areas for this corridor. The corridor envisages multiple things, including industrial parks, housing amenities. Many things are being worked out. So certain land in the surrounding DPL area will also be with WBIDC, which would be used for development of this corridor. Exact nature that what will be the use for that land, of course, that we'll be getting from consultations like this. EY can find out what is the best use for that. So my only additional input apart from this is that you may keep that in mind. As and when we are sure that what would be the nature of the parcels of land and what use we would be putting that into, we'll certainly come back to you, take your feedback. But in the meantime, you can just understand those land which will also be in addition to what DPL is doing. And rest assured, everything is being done in consultative mode, and we would also learn from what DPL is doing and what is the best use. So we will make use of that. I again thank DPL for inviting me here. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. We'd also like to welcome those who have joined online from Jharkhand. I think we have our Jharkhand State Council chairman who has joined, and all the other investors have joined. So thanks a lot for joining. So before we go into the question answer session, we'll request Mr. Suresh Kumar, Regional Chief Secretary, for his keynote address. Thank you, sir.
Mr. Pradeep Sureka on the dais. Chairman ICC, my good friend Anurag, my colleagues on the dais, Mr. Datta and Mrs. Chandana, and other dignitaries who have come for this exchange of thoughts about the monetization of land. Basically, DPL was a big zamindar once upon a time. So like all zamindars, it's gone through bad times, but it's looking up. And we feel that actually that there's no point holding on to land nowadays. It's best to be monetize it. Otherwise, it's going to get encroached. And I can tell you for one that we already have a fair amount of land which is already encroached. So we have given it up. We've forgotten about it. And whatever is left is what we need to monetize. So that's the basic rationale of the whole thing. And mercifully, we don't see any great encroachments happening off late. So we did a little bit of a prachar there and said, you know, we'll throw people out and so on and so forth, so that somehow managed to reduce the encroachment which is happening. We have, I think, 3 to 4 categories of land available. Between what is going to be monetized by, say, DPL or by, whatever is going to be done by ENY is basically of two types. Industrial, commercial, and the residential. Now, if you were to see this, like for example, lands which are outside Durgapur are eminently residential, commercial sort of a thing, which you know you could look at. The Bali land right next to the station, wonderful land. This was acquired once upon a time for the gas grid project, but was never used actually. So we've just put a compound wall and put a guard there and is happily looking after the place. Similarly, the Dhaniagali land also was for the gas grid project. The Badhavan land also is for the gas grid project. They somehow didn't. So these are all now in prime areas and definitely can be looked at as a very good residential commercial activity. In Durgapur, which of course is the major center, economic center now, we have land around our plant, DPL plant, which is at Anaman Sarani. That definitely is going to be industrial zone, for which WBIDC is definitely looking at it much more strongly as to how do we maximize or leverage the best out of it. Then we also have certain lands around our township, which can be a very good commercial proposition. That also IDC is looking at that. And so they that process is on. Then we have land within the heart of the city, you know, where you have the hospital, you have all the institutional area of Durgapur, right in the heart of the city, which we call the Bidhannagar area. We have around 120 acres, which we have preserved carefully after, I mean, everyone was trying to encroach on that. Somehow we have managed to keep out, and that is available for monetization. Our policy, I mean, what I've been told also, and what I think also I believe in, is we monetize the whole area, whatever is there. We're not interested actually in doing anything like part by part. It's not going to make any sense to anyone. Example, we have a benchmark cost, something other will be evolved, I suppose. And if it meets the benchmark cost, we'll monetize it. If it doesn't, then probably we will wait for some more time. But effectively, we want to look at all the plots so that, you know, we can get as many people trying to come in to take participate and not make it a very narrow and a restrictive process. So this is something which I want to make it very clear right at the start. The third thing is that we want to revive the industrial activity in Durgapur. Now, of course, Durgapur went through lots of cycles of development, but what we found actually is that there are issues related to the price of power. Now, even DVC, in fact, is now hiked the prices of power, for which a lot of people are again coming back to the WBACDCL, saying that, you know, we want to take your power. So we are now ramping up our own transmission and the distribution capacity because our tariffs are lower. We want to further lower the tariff also. The normal way which we operate in our electricity sector is we use cross subsidy to ensure that industry subsidizes domestic consumers. We're going to take a hit in that process, but we want to promote industry. So we are working very actively to ensure that at 33 and at 11 also, industries will get cheaper power. So, I mean, the process is on. And this, if it happens, I'm sure you'll have industries coming in droves there. Okay. And that's the reason why, you know, not polluting. I mean, basically, since, you know, Durgapur is actually a residential area in some sense, you know, the environmental issues could be an area. But, you know, if you don't have smokestack industries and you would have any other type of an industry which doesn't have much effluence, I'm sure that place will be completely different. The corridor is also coming up. Industrial corridor is also coming up. This available land will definitely be the nucleus for further development of Durgapur and its vicinity. So this is an offering that we have, and I'm sure should be attractive. How can we make it more attractive is what we mean. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. I think we'll now just open the house and we'll look for your suggestions, comments, observations, as you would like to say.
Good afternoon, good evening, sir. Thank you so much for, you know, such a positive and open address, giving us a window into what's going to be available for us to develop over the next few years. Sir, as a background, as an introduction, I'm Apoor Salarpuria. I represent the Salarpuria group. We have completed one residential project in Durgapur in the Bidhanagar area. In fact, it's called Salarpuria Gardenia. And sir, you know, my humble submission on in terms of or suggestion in terms of the monetization would be, sir, that we are ultimately as an industry able to offer best prices when we are able to factor in everything, when we don't have hidden kind of surprises or things which we have to evaluate after bidding. And I'll give you things. I'm not talking about Durgapur or any particular kind of land in particular. It's in general with, you know, bidding processes with government. So, sir, one of the things which we often kind of struggle with is whether ULC is going to be required to be taken by us over and above this, or is it something which is going to be made available, only a procedural application is required. So that is one thing which comes up every time, sir. The other thing, you know, whether, you know, having worked in this area, you know, there are certain areas with our, which are within the ADDA planning area, certain areas which are outside. And there are certain charges as well as restrictions, etc., which come along with ADDA involvement. So clarity on those would again help us bid more efficiently and get a better yield for the government. And sir, of course, you know, freehold versus leasehold is something which I'm sure you will decide. But the only kind of little piece I want to add there in terms of leasehold is that there is a GST implication which we struggle with whenever government land is getting monetized on a leasehold format. There are certain bodies we understand which are exempt. So in case you do decide to go on a leasehold format, you know, we would appreciate if we could get clarity on the GST piece, because it's a substantial amount which gets added to the bidding. And maybe if it won't be applicable, but in as a bidder, we tend to include that as a cost and then calculate back. So these are just a few things which came, you know, upfront in mind, sir. And of course, we hope to engage with you on a continuous basis as you move ahead with this process. Thank you so much.
I will just add to what Apoorva said. It is not only the GST, sir, in the lease, because we are dealing on a lot of government land which is leased. There are a lot of restrictions and transfers later on when we are selling. So those also, you know, become a, you see, the processes when we are doing on a positive note everything. It's urban land ceiling is also then conversion, change of use. I mean, right now most of your lands may be industrial plots. So once you do decide if there is going to be a restriction on a use of your plot, now whether we are supposed to go and get that change or whether you will, so better that if it is, you know, properly cooked, then you will be able to get the best price out of it. So free should be master. I mean, that's our request. Change of use, as he said, who's the sanctioning authority. The other problem sometimes happens if their land is far in this thing, then utilities. That becomes a huge cost on hidden costs. Since you're already the power and the stormwater discharge. In any large plots, these are the two of the biggest challenges, stormwater discharge and the power. Everything else can be taken care of, utility, sewage, and things like that can be taken care of, say, in the title, of course, sir, you will definitely be, as you did mention in your talk, that you have acquired certain lands. Now, that should not lead to a PIL, should not lead to a problem in the court tomorrow. So that particular angle, sir, I would request ENY to definitely examine. And sir, please don't keep your thresholds much above your circle rates. Otherwise,
the benchmark rate is not going to be fixed by me or anyone. My finance department will determine it. But I think they're going to be reasonable.
Yeah. You know, it's always, you can't go back.
I know.
You can go up.
Yes. Just to... the Alipur and the...
markets, I think the prices were very competitively, reserve prices were fixed very competitively, and the eventual result, of course, was much higher because it gave people to participate knowing that it's not going to be a bar. And, you know, price, of course, as you're aware, was substantially higher than the reserve price.
Even that Taliban CTC one.
Right. No, sir, I will. There is one government department which tried to auction a land. They set their benchmark so high. They had a transaction advisor again. Nobody came to bid.
So that's something which is the main concern for us, that, you know, we need adequate competition also. If you don't have enough competition, then also it becomes a infructuous affair, actually. That's the reason why we're trying to see if as many people can come by. Now, regarding change of land use and all that, I mean, since we are trying to promote industrialization, probably I mean, a significant portion of the land is kept aside for that particular purpose.
No problem.
So I just hope that, you know, that land is available, you could, you know, start doing industrial estates also with non-polluting units as much as you can. And definitely you can pick up. And power is going to be not an issue. The price of power. Not just the power, the price of power, actually.
Sir, I am Rachid from Merlin Group, sir. So just one point about in some of these leasehold properties, sir, mortgage rights are generally restricted, sir.
I know, but
sir, if we can have some flexibility with that, sir.
It's going to be free.
Oh, that's great. Thank you.
No, sir, I think you could restrict your land use. You could decide that this is going to be industrial. Industry also, you could make it a little wider, sir. My suggestion that it warehousing, it could be
Logistics are a part of industry now.
So it could be, sir.
In fact, the policy of logistics is coming out. Okay, it's coming out.
So because especially where you have lands again next to the railway stations could be very useful for warehousing or logistics. Yeah.
I think we are all
doing industrial projects today.
I think the position of the government has been that where it is purely monetization, like real estate, there the freehold is not an issue. When it comes to industrial plot, I think that is where we will have to have a more detailed debates, and that's where the mortgage rights, we will have to ensure that it is.
No, but now they have issued an order saying that if it's going to be a utility which is selling the land, it will be freehold. That's all. At rents. This is something which we've been fighting for a very long time internally, more than a year plus. So it's come off now, luckily. For us, it's a godsend.
I don't know if it is possible. Like, I developed a land bought from government in Sri Lanka, where they said, I'm giving it to you on lease right now, but the ultimate user gets freehold. So I'm restricting it in that period of development. So you cannot misutilize the land, if that is what your scare is. But the actual user, once he gets it for the industry or whatever, he gets it free.
That from government point of view, sir, you know, we always talk about our side of the story. I think, sir, it's also equally important that the land is taken by genuine people who are going to develop the land. Because even as an industry, we don't want that people buy the land, sit on it, and then kind of trade on it later. So anything which kind of takes care of that, we also welcome it as an industry.
The other thing that we actually wanted some feedback is that on the industrial part, we've got lands of 25 acres, 20 acres. Some of them are adjacent to each other, which can be accumulated and gone in one size. So we also wanted your input on size should go, how much should be written, and or maybe should go for a subplot. There's also some feedback that we have that you make a plot and, you know, give these plots out. Now, the ones in Durgapur are very well located and with all sorts of questions right besides the DPL plants. So that is one input on the industrial part is what would be useful.
So can we give them some sort of a soft copy of what we have? I mean, this is too sketchy, a little bit more detailed. So plot wise, if you can give maybe a drone picture also along
To answer Sudeep's question,
then you think they can give us better feedback. Actually,
in South City, we've done an industrial park development of about 45 acres. That's South City, sir.
Okay,
we did an industrial park in Havra, which the first one was with the WBSD. First phase is 25 acres. So 25 acres is a good industrial plot development. If you break it up,
then it goes against the idea.
You will create the infrastructure.
Correct.
Then you can sell the plots by it. Then either you become the developer, no problem.
So, you know, we would like to keep the plots as large as possible and give it up. So what sir will do is that we will give the set with a little more details to ICC and to Mr. Surek. I think then look for something from ICC. It will be easier for us to take in that input. So this with some details we'll share and then maybe could circulate and come up with more. So
once you have a broad IM, we can select, if you like, 10, 20, 25, 30 potential developers. Get their feedback, suggestions.
We can do one more. We have no problem about this thing.
We can even organize a visit. We can fix 2 or 3 days to visit Durgapur. You know, bunch of 5-7 people can go on each visit. So, you know, you have a... Because everybody is not that familiar with Durgapur.
I think only he is probably. Others are still looking blank about Durgapur.
So, you know, Durgapur or any other lands. Good locations.
Sure. But I mean, as since I've been going to Durgapur quite a few times, I've seen that, though I didn't work in that area, the land per se is very good. Yeah, nothing. You don't need to do any further development on that. That's the best part. Normally, costs of filling, etc., are all major issues. They're all developed plans, actually.
Sir, is there a time frame to this whole exercise?
I mean, exercise, see, we cannot prolong an exercise on and on. Of course, now we have a puja coming up. So we just want to and then put out the bid document after the puja.
So when are the RFIs?
That's what I was saying. We want to conclude within the end of this month, put our discussion, etc. And after the puja is over, we want to put up our request for proposals.
Well, the lands are all available, so there is no issue. Approval of the government is in place. So, this process or whatever suggestion.
Idea that we could organize, organize activities that people can go and see the land that will make a lot more sense. And that, and then obviously, people will do that when they want to do it, but before that, as an exercise, also.
Yeah.
I think then you will get a better feedback.
We'll provide a coach, all of you will get into it and go.
No, I think whoever's interested would like to go, sir.
It's up to you all. Like the way we are all hurt, shepherded and sent off to the district lab, we can all take the coach and go. No issues.
You can organize, ICC can help organize along with Sudeep is there. And,
I think we can do a one-day trip. That's good enough.
Mm-hmm. No, so I think, you know, to get everybody on that same day may not be
possible. We'll have to
give 2 or 3 days.
Yeah.
And let people choose any of those 2 days. Your team is already there.
There. So
we can get some nodal officer or somebody who can.
No, no, we have an establishment running there.
Right. So somebody
issues about that.
Days people can nominate somebody from DPL.
DPL is always there.
That will be sufficient.
So, whatever industry comes and goes, DPL remains.
So, what we'll do is we'll do in the February, also visit Titus also. I think those plots are there, so we can show them.
The contact person would be Ms. Chandana for this?
Yeah.
Okay. So, Ms. Chandana, on behalf of our transaction advisor, is the contact. Any other questions beside? Anyone from Jharkhand would like to talk?
I just asked them, sir, whether he wants any questions.
So we have to do a show there also.
Any questions, Prashad, sir? You have any queries? Yeah, because maybe we will do a road. The government here wants to do a road show in Jharkhand, so we'll plan that also. He's very, he heads the Adani group in Jharkhand.
So. Mm-hmm.
that's the Adani group in Jharkhand. So Jharkhand is basically Adani, Zimtas.
So I think a little bit of a some sort of a subtle message should go into the realty sector sites and
all that.
That are available also for monetization.
Sure.
Yeah. So we do that. So we have a good presentation. I think I
So is those of are online? Anybody would like to ask some questions? There are about 6-7 people online. But are we going to check with if this?
Soil condition is really important.
Oh, it's very hard soil there.
There's no filling, filling is not chemical. Like when we took over the Usha factory, we take off the top layer of soil because of, you know, being in industrial land.
No. These are all lands. They're lying like that.
There is no land. No land or something like that.
There is not even low land also.
Correct. So,
Muswak?
Dr. Prasad. Haji.
Hello.
Please.
Good afternoon.
Haji.
Good afternoon, everybody. So I think it is a very welcome move and very nicely presented. I just saw the entire proceeding. And maybe it's an excellent opportunity to unlock the potential and the unutilized land, whatever is DPL is holding. It's a very, very brilliant move. And I wish you all a great success. Of course, we can learn from it for even for Jharkhand. And basically what people would prefer that it should be free from any kind of encumbrances. And of course, the utilities certainly being so close to Durgapur, the utilities would be available, as Suresh Kumar sir has explained very nicely. And basically, it is the attitude that we are saying is so positive. I am quite sure that things are going to materialize very soon. And keeping a timeline to the entire activity will certainly take it a long way, and people will get interested, certainly. So this is what a few things which I would like to add. That is all. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Dr. Prasad. Manish ji, aap kuch kahenge kya? Nahi, aapka mic on karna padega.
I think I am Manish. I am representing a company called Dynamic Tarang, and we have been active on food processing, hospitals, hotels, and bamboo processing. Well, this particular move by government of West Bengal, I think, is a welcome step as altogether. We at Ranchi has definite interest in Bengal because our primary market is based in Calcutta. So most of our raw material also are sourced from here, all the traders and all that. So definitely we have interest in West Bengal. The only thing is that I about this nitty-gritty thing, everybody understands that, yes, businesses would be looking for a headache-free investment opportunity. Because if you put our money and based on our own money, we buy headaches. So this become a very painful thing. So definitely, as Dr. Prasad said, that should be all this H3 transfers. Number two, I suggest to develop a proper information flow system. Exactly, because we live outside, so possibly we may not be able to understand what developments are going on or what consultative processes are going on. So better if we can have a WhatsApp group or say a website kind of thing, which force people to join, means attract people from join, not only from Jharkhand, either from Orissa, Bihar, or other part of the country. The second area that I want to force on, that you will easily get bigger investors to jump on, but some portions would be definitely be marked out for smaller units. You know, they may not be able to procure, say, 24 acres of land. Possibly they would be looking to set up a SME unit in 10,000 square feet of land. You know, that and definitely that will generate the low investment capacity people to come forward and put up their money and set up smaller units as well. So that would be my suggestion from my side. And definitely when more consultations will be there, possibly I'll be definitely be putting my views into it. So that information system means a flow of information system must be there. Thanks.
Anyone else from Ranchi?
Sir, if just one more query that I had, that if some document could be circulated beforehand to the interested parties or the investors or the people in the industry, then I think many of them would get interested in doing some interesting projects. So if some document could come to us, so even the bigger builders, this is, I think, an excellent opportunity which they would not like to miss.
Sure. I think our transaction advisor will definitely work on that part. He's a quite capable set of people. You still think, is it worthwhile to do a roadshow there in Ranchi?
It may be possible to do a roadshow in Ranchi. There's not an issue. And I would feel that there would be people interested. But let's do some, some homework on this. And after this, we can get back to you. But my hunch is that it will be a good, very good step that you can take.
Sure. Thank you. Thank you, Dr. Prasad. Thank you, Manishji.
Thank you, sir.
Over to you.
So is there any other suggestions or anything else? So thanks a lot. I think the whole idea was to start sensitizing on the availability of this. This project document, we will further develop and share with ICC. We look for your suggestions on this, and maybe a suggestion document which can then be taken across as we prepare the bid process. Once again, all of the lands of encroachment clear ownership by DPL, and the urban utilization could be are well defined. So we have a complete transparent selection process. The idea, of course, would be to get the best possible. Because it's not just monetization, it is also to ensure that the lands are put to the best use. With this, I think, thanks a lot for everyone. Please join us for some for tea, and we could. And please do let our contact. I think we'll just share our numbers with you, all of you. So please do contact us if you would like to move to the see the sites or need any further clarifications. Okay. So I'll create a WhatsApp. I'll just take a basis here. We'll create a WhatsApp group with all other members. We'll share our numbers and connection on this. Thank you so much.
Great. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. Thank you. It's a pleasure when I meet you. And you are so much full of life all the time.
Shall we log off?